Hello and greetings from Iceland. It's hard to say right now if this update is good or bad news, but it will become more clear in the next 2-3 days. It has to be good news though that the Blue Lagoon opened for business yesterday, December 17th, but the hotels there, they will remain closed for a while at least. But on the downside, it's only possible to go there with a Blue Lagoon bus from Reykjavik or Keflavik, since the main road remains closed. But that will change soon. And as for the land uplift, in my last update I mentioned that it might be slowing down. It seemed to be the case for a few days. And I guess it's the main reason why the Blue Lagoon could open up again. And experts say that there are a few ways to interpret what the seismometers and the GPS devices are saying now. And the most likely explanation might be that the magma inflow is about to stop and this event might be fading out. But it's also a possibility that the rock around has stretched to the limits now. They have a certain amount of flexibility and we might see something snap soon and even lead to an eruption. That's one of the theories out there. And the earthquakes these days are more irregular than usual. And I notice more of them at a little depth. And overall, we are moving over this critical point that I mentioned in my last update, where the land is at the same position as it was before the November 10th event. So the next days might lay out how the future will be. And the opening of the Blue Lagoon will put a lot of pressure on opening the town, as the infrastructure there is already usable. And the news of the day is about this restaurant owner that tried to stay at home in town during night time, and he managed to do so for a few days until the police got to him and escorted him out of town. And there is also pressure from experts to open the town, like the media did recently do a story about this popular volcano blog, where one of our volcanologists is sharing his thoughts, Professor Haraldur Sigurdsson, and he's a respected scientist with over 60 years of experience, and saying that it is nonsense to keep the town closed and make the residents suffer more than they already have. And the event we just went through is primarily a tectonic shift, and way more pressure is needed to get the magma up, and since we have gone through all this without an eruption so far, it is most likely not going to happen this time. So the heat is on, but not under the town this time, and it was announced this morning that the town might open up for full-time stay next Wednesday, or if we get a few more quiet days like we have been seeing now, with little or no land uplift. So I'm already planning my next trip to the peninsula with the thermal drone, but the time I have until Christmas is getting shorter, and I have a Christmas mood video in the making, plus one more update at least before Christmas. So the only way to justify such a trip now would be to do some flying and filming on the way as well. And I do actually have many targets for the drone near Grindavik. Like here near the Blue Lagoon, I need to fly over this spot or where I was filming with the thermal drone almost every day before the November 10th event. So I have a good thermal map already from there. And I would like to see the ground temperature has changed. I'm actually getting questions about the thermal drone footage in the comment section all the time now. And I know you miss the footage from it, and me too. So I will do my best. And there are more areas around that require comparison videos, not just from the thermal drone. We have new lava barriers to film as well. And I would also like to fly over this fracture that just opened up. And I have actually more tasks to do on the peninsula. I would like to do thermal tour number 5 over the highway by the volcano Hengill, or the part of it that's been warming up due to increased geothermal activity. And since I'm talking about the Hengill volcano, I have to mention a few odd earthquakes that require some attention, since Hengill is one of those systems that's been teasing us every now and then. And its location, when it comes to the tectonic plates, is quite odd. It sits on a triple junction, and the last eruption occurred 1900 years ago, but a massive rifting episode in 1789 led to major changes in our national park, Þingvellir, where the land by the lake subsided up to 2 meters. Earthquakes are common in Hengil and the surrounding area in the years 1994 to 99. About 25,000 earthquakes were detected there and it's believed that it had to do with the magma flowing into the magma chamber around there, this part of Hengil. A separate volcano, but a part of the Hengil system, called Hrómundartindur. And this event that stopped in 1999, it confirmed that this system is very much alive and the magma chamber is at a little depth, perhaps as little as 3-4 kilometers. So this warming highway is a story worth following. And I've always sensed Hengil volcano as both terrifying and fascinating. I've driven over it and by it hundreds of times, and when I started drone flying, it became my subject instantly. But it is one of the volcanoes that needs a few days of work to do it justice, so I need way more footage from there. Especially since we have already seen how extremely useful my video collection from Grindavik turned out to be, where I could show videos from all angles while the area was closed. So my plans are clear. Keep on gathering footage from there, and in my next update, I will be talking about if the people can return, if I have some really good news, and we hope so. If the town will open up next Wednesday, I might try to do a short trip pending on weather. So let's see about that. And until then, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.